Hi, my name is Cathy Toms, and I'm from the medical laboratories. And this is Holly Bradley Carter. And we're going to make a film today on the actual procedure for drawing blood. The first thing you want to do is make sure that you have the correct patient. So therefore, in our outpatient area, we ask the patient to state their name and date of birth. Ma'am, what is your name?
My name is Alice Smith, and my date of birth is July 4th, 1959.
Okay, thank you very much. If she were an inpatient, I would actually check her hospital band and make sure that all the numbers match the request form that I have so that we can compare exactly and make sure that every number is exactly right and every letter in the name is spelled right. Okay, first thing we're going to do is put our tourniquet 3 to 4 inches above the antecubital area. This is the choice site that you would want to stick somebody for a blood sample. I'm going to tie this rather tight. You want to make sure that you do the loop over the top so that it doesn't hang down in your way, and also so you can release it with one hand, because at the very end of the procedure, you're only going to have one hand free to release the tourniquet. Okay, you want to make sure that the patient's arm is in a good position. There are sometimes things that you can put under their elbow, a roll of paper towels, a rolled up towel, a rolled up blue pad sometimes makes a good padding for support under the patient's arm. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is clean the area after I decide which vein I'm going to use. I'm going to palpate across the area. And you want to feel a vein will be very spongy, very giving. So she has an excellent vein right here. And I'm going to clean it with an alcohol pad. I'm going to clean from the inside out. And you want to let the alcohol air dry. So you will have to wait for about 30 to 40 seconds while the alcohol air dries. Now we're going to draw on her today. We're going to draw a CBC, which is a purple top. We're going to draw some chemistry, so we're going to need a green top. And we're going to draw a proton, so we would need a blue top too. I'm going to use a 21-gauge needle, which comes in a black sheath. And I'm going to make sure that I break the seal. And this screws into the barrel. This is a safety holder, by the way. This is not going to do anything until at the end where we're finished. We're going to snap it over the needle, so it's a safety device for the phlebotomist. Okay. I'm going to put my gloves on. You notice I do not have to put my gloves on until I actually get ready to do the stick. Okay. I'm going to remove the needle holder cap, and I'm going to make sure that my bevel is up. I'm going to anchor the vein with my thumb. I'm going to pull the skin taut, and I'm going to enter the skin in a quick fluid motion. Notice that the tube is not pushed onto the holder, onto the needle, until I've entered the vein. If you push the tube on before you enter the vein, the vacuum will be gone out of your tube. At this point, I'm going to let the tube fill automatically until it actually stops. The blue top tube is the only tube that has to be full, and that is because of the anticoagulant ratio in the tube. You want to make sure you mix it well, pick up your other tube, and push it onto the holder. Let it fill naturally. You want to make sure when you pull the tube off that you're not moving the needle in the patient's arm. And this is going to be my last tube. And this is a 3 ml tube, so it will not fill totally up. And I'm going to release the tourniquet while my last tube is filling. I'm going to lay some gauze over the needle here. I'm going to take the last tube off before you withdraw the needle. And then I'm going to apply pressure, withdraw the needle swiftly. Ma'am, could you hold that, please? Now, you want to make sure that you snap the safety device on the needle so it's totally covered, and then you want to dispose of it in a contaminated box. You want to make sure that you label the tubes with the appropriate name and history number. I'm going to write Mrs. Smith's name on here. Alice Smith. And her history number is 756423. Alice Smith, 756423. Alice Smith, 756423. And I'm going to put my blood in a Ziploc bag. And in the pocket bag, you want to insert the request form. And you would send this to the laboratory. I'm going to put a clean piece of gauze on her arm and a little piece of tape. All right, ma'am, you can take the tape off in about 30 minutes after it's stopped. I'll throw that away for you. You want to make sure that you remove your gloves and wash your hands between each patient.